10 o'clock, and welcome to the cabinet on Monday the 26th of March. Members called the conduct, any declarations of interest? Nancy Clare, thank you. Two apologies for absence, if we can be recorded, please. Angie Davis and Phil Davis. Minutes of last meeting. Minutes of August, do you agree that I sign them?
Agreed.
And then could I have your indulgence just for 1 minute? Chris, where's Chris? Chris, I know you've got another appointment to go to and you've got to be away and be there for 10:30. So can we take with your indulgence item 8, please, first?
Thank you, Bill.
Thank you, Chris.
This is the annual report that we, this is the annual report that we bring around the fee setting for this year, 2018-19, and it's to report the outcome of consultation with care providers with regard to next year's fee rates for services for adults and older people. I'm really proud that after extensive consultation with the care providers, that we're proposing an investment of almost £3 million for next year. The consultation has covered all services provided on behalf of Will Adult Social Care and Will CCG as part of the joint commissioning arrangements. And the report covers all sectors, so it's residential and nursing, domiciliary care, and the actual rises and fees are in the table on page 60 and 61. And particularly we've looked this time at travel time, which is obviously really important. And on page 72, you can see where we sit with other boroughs, so we're midpoint, more or less, on all the areas. And I'd ask the Cabinet to agree the recommendations, which are on page 58.
Thank you, Chris. Any questions from any member of the Cabinet? For the board, the recommendations that are written on page 58, as we said. Can we approve those comments?
Agreed.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you, Chris. Then we go back to agenda item 3, please, which is the exact key decisions taken in the federal powers and one for Phil, for the record, and we'll go say a couple of words to you, Phil.
Thanks, George. I'll just speak very briefly on the creation of the Climate Change Annual Report Action Plan. Climate change affects us all. We see its impact every day. So weather becomes more extreme, infrastructure designed to withstand the conditions of yesterday struggle to contend with the environment of today. I believe that it's beholden on us to do all we can in the face of this, adapting where we must and changing what we can. Wherever councils have stripped their organisation of the expertise required for a well-informed, expert approach to climate change, rural probably retains that asset. I want to thank the Rural Climate Change Group for their continuing hard work as highlighting the Cool Steps Annual Progress Report, and Brian Lipscomb in particular for his passion, expertise and commitment to this worthy cause. Residents should be in no doubt that the environment is a priority for this council, not some pious afterthought. The report sets out progress of the year, notably building capacity for action, which is very much linked to our Before You Live campaign, where we work with local groups to improve the environment around them. Also, resilient parks. Our parks in Perth have worked with climate change experts to make parks more resilient to climate change. This has included drainage systems and changes to the plant species used within the planting scheme. It also sets out the strategy action plan, an ambitious document that we hope to achieve in the year to come. This includes sustainable corporate decision making, that's the adoption of a sustainability appraisal tool to inform decision making on growing housing, transport and community interaction. also public messaging and awareness campaigns. Not only with our climate strategy action plan allow us to meet our climate and local commitments, but to their declaration of intent, I want our stunning peninsula to lead the region as the greenest, most progressive and innovative local authority, set the environment for what we do. I invite and encourage other local authorities to follow where we lead. Thank you.
Thank you, Phil.
Brian has done excellent work on this report year in and year out, and I think it's good that we mention officers when they do such brilliant work. It's a bit of a resource to this, isn't it? It's a good report, and he's done a lot of hard work on it, so well done.
Thanks, Ben. Okay, moving on to item 4, which is nomination of Civic Mayor for 2018-19, and cabinet requested to make the nominations. But one is the mayor for the following ensuing year is Geoffrey Watt, and the deputy mayor for 18-19 is Tony Smith. That means the most approval. Thank you. Then we move to item 5, which is the World Court Strategy Local Plan. Will employment land and premises too. Again, this is a part of an extensive and detailed process of producing a local plan for Will. It is vital that the full understanding of the employment land, which is enshrined into this document, it tells you exactly where we believe it should be, where we've had land in particular over the past 15 years. In particular, I mentioned one piece of land which is up in Rhondda. It's been there 15 years, we haven't been able to develop it. We look at them sort of things and basically say, is it in the right place or is it residential? So therefore, each piece of land across the world will be designated either into employment or into residential. So we've got the report in front of us. Is that okay to meet with everyone on the callus?
Agreed.
Can I just say, I think if I make a statement, please, I'd like to, because I mean, people will have been aware that in the over the weekend we've had notice from Senator David that he is he's been basically saying get your housing in order. I'd like to respond to that and basically saying Senator David and his Tory colleagues are dead wrong. It is for the rural residents through rural council to determine what our housing needs are and where new homes should be built. We neither welcome nor appreciate Secretary of State's overtly political intervention. I also very much doubt Steve Rodham and our colleagues in the Liverpool City region welcome being used as a pawn in the government's continued attack on local authorities. Is in disagreement with us and his own civil servants about our current local plan schedule, he is entitled to his opinion. But Will is not going to accept Whitehall bureaucrats coming up and telling us we must meet the Tory central government targets for building on our greenbelt. We have said repeatedly we want to see extensive permissions acted upon and brownfield developments like the ones just announced at Little Waters, action first. Wirral's housing needs are not the same as central London or the South East. We need a mix of affordable homes, first-time buyers' homes, and housing for families and an ageing population across the borough. Wirral alone should decide how best to achieve that. Tory ministers are not needed. And can I just finish up by saying, when setting our housing and employment targets, Wirral's Labour Council had to wait for our colleagues in the city region to do theirs, and with the announcement of the Wirral Growth Company, we wanted to make economic targets that were ambitious enough. We've been in contact with civil servants in the DCLG for some time. They told us we don't have a housing crisis like in London, and they're comfortable with the time frame we've set. Sajid David is dead wrong and contradicting the actions of his own officials. He has no need all right to start coming here and telling us how to set targets. We need to where to build best, and decisions are made best on the needs and wishes of local residents. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much indeed. Comments? Any further comments? Janet?
Just a brief one, really. Thanks for that, George. What shape of the government ministers aren't as eager to intervene when we've asked them over the past few years to come and help them with our general funding crisis within this council? And more lastly, when I wrote to the fire minister to intervene on the swinging force that Merseyside Fire and Rescue Service have endured. So wouldn't it be nice if they were as quick to focus their attention on Royal Council where we've asked them to?
Thank you, Janet.
Okay, Councillor Green?
Yeah.
McKinney? Councillor Seck? We move to item six, Highway Structural Maintenance Programme 2018-19. Stuart?
Thank you, Chair. I'm delighted to be asking Cabinet's approval to accept £2.6 million from the Bulls City Region Combined Authority to invest in our highways network assets after we report. The quality of our highways network is a key priority for local residents. This is also a key priority for myself and this administration, and also supports delivering the rural plan. In the rural plan, one of our pledges is transport and technology infrastructure fit for the future. That said, our highways and transport networks support most, if not all, of our pledges in the rural plan, whether it's delivering care services in the community or the family day out to our wonderful coastal countryside, then our transport networks are there to help make it happen. I would like to ask Cabinet to read the recommendations assessed out on page 22 of the government's plan. Thank you very much.
Any further comments, please? Okay. Then we've got the recommendations as on page 22. Four recommendations for you there. Read those recommendations. Thank you very much indeed. Move to seven, which is the transport plan for growth. 18-19 again, Mr. Stewart, please.
Thank you, George. Again, I'm delighted to be asking Cabinet's approval to accept £1.1 million from the Liverpool City Region Combined Authority to invest in a programme of road improvements across the borough as part of our transport council group, which all set out in the report. I think this is great news and supports our pledges in the world plan. I would ask Cabinet to brief recommendations, which are set out on page 46 of the documents pack.
Are we okay with that, Cabinet?
Yeah.
All agreed?
Agreed.
Thank you very much indeed. We'll move to 7, 8, I think that is it. That is it. That's okay. General of the public comments, thank you very much indeed. Members of the public, can I ask you to move the exemption? Thank you. It is recommended that under section 108, Book 4 of the Local Government Act 1972, the public be excluded from the meeting during consideration of the following items of business on the grounds that they involve the likely disclosure of exempt information as defined by paragraph 3 of part 1 of Schedule 12A as amended to that Act. The public interest test has been applied and failed to exclude. Thank you very much indeed.
Seconded.
Seconded.